Gong Show presents reviews for films opening this weekend. If you're in Japan or thinking about spending your hard-earned cash on a movie this coming weekend, or if you're in another country thinking about spending money to rent or download a movie, you'll want to listen carefully as we have some very critical reviews by this guy. Say hi, Don.
Hi, Don.
That's Metropolis film critic Don Morton. What movies this week, Don?
Six movies opening this week. We have Drive Hard, Nurse 3D, Good People, Annabelle, Chef, and Predestination.
Shall we start with worst first?
Worst first it is.
All right. Let's start with this one. This is called
Drive Hard. This is an amazingly unfunny Australian buddy comedy starring Thomas Jane and John Cusack. Thomas Jane plays a washed-up race car driver who's abducted by a criminal, Cusack, and forced to be the getaway driver in a bank heist. They banter insipidly. What happened to John Cusack? He used to be an A-lister. You could watch him in anything. Thomas Jane's talents, I don't really know what they are, but I'm pretty sure comedy isn't one of them. This is tasteless. It's amateurish, it's repetitive, it's poorly filmed, and the acting's awful. All of the acting.
What about car chases?
The whole movie is a car chase, and for a movie called Drive Hard, with a lot of cars, the car chases are comically slow and repetitive and poorly edited. It's not even trashy fun. This one is a real dog.
How many dogs?
A pack of dogs. Oh. Let's move on to Nurse 3D. This is a movie about a slutty, psychotic nurse who lethally punishes misbehaving males in a variety of gruesome and imaginative ways.
Is this a picture of her right here?
That's her.
Ooh.
You'd think this would be funny. It should be a lot funnier. It should be funny at all. It's not. Paz de la Huerta is my new least favorite actress. She plays the title nurse, and her constant mugging kind of takes the fun out of any titillation that might be derived from the fact that she apparently disdains clothing in general. This is witness. It's self-satisfied. I have no idea why it's in 3D.
Sexy?
Blood-spattered sexy.
Next movie is called Good People.
A better title would be Stupid People or Moronic People.
Oh.
It's about an American couple in London who they find a bag of money in the basement flat they rent to a guy who's clearly a crook and who just died of a heroin overdose. Of course, they decide to keep the money.
Why would anyone want to do that?
Well, obviously, they never go to movies because this is a common theme and it never turns out good. James Franco and Kate Hudson play the couple so blandly they nearly disappear, though. In Franco's case, this is a plus. The final confrontation with the bad guys happens in a house that's being refurbished, and it reminded me more of Home Alone than anything. This is a real turkey.
Who's this pretty face?
That's Annabelle. And here's a fresh idea. How about a movie about a creepy antique doll?
People still go to movies about scary dolls?
Well, we'll see. We'll see about that. This is a cheapo prequel focusing on the backstory of the title doll that appeared in The Conjuring, a much better movie. It's a cash grab. It offers nothing remotely original. The music's oppressive. The acting's anemic. The dialogue is labored, and it plagiarizes from other films. At least the doll is not animated. They did that in Chucky already. Let's get into some good movies now. This one's called Chef. Now, if you know anything about the career of director, writer, actor Jon Favreau, you'll see this as a bit autobiographical. He started out with personal films like Swingers and Made, and then he went on to direct Iron Man and Cowboys and Aliens, and now he's coming back to Earth with this little personal movie. It's about a talented chef who quits his job in a prestigious but unadventurous restaurant to get back to his creative culinary roots. And he does this in a beat-up old Cuban sandwich truck. He's sold out, and now he's selling back in. There's not a lot of drama here, but it's knowledgeable about food, and it's continually amusing. It's more relaxed, like a slow food cinematic meal.
Movie for foodies?
And music. There's some great R&B, salsa, and funk music in it. The cast is just super.
Next movie seems, well, predetermined.
This is Predestination. Forget free will. There's, you know, a lot of movies, sci-fi movies these days are just eye candy.
Yeah.
Well, this one is brain candy. It's complex, it's paradoxical, it's a time travel mind messer that mixes elements of like Looper, Memento, and Back to the Future. It's a high concept, low budget, and very entertaining existential puzzle, and it rewards people that go to the movies and like to think.
What's the source of this material?
It's based on a 1959 short story by Robert Hyland called All You Zombies. Stars Ethan Hawke, he's the main character, a sort of time cop chasing an elusive terrorist. While he's working undercover in another time, he happens to fall in conversation with a fellow whose backstory is a real mind and gender bender. Sarah Snook plays this person in a knockout performance.
No, I've never heard of Sarah Snook.
Well, you will. She shows in this movie more range than most actors do in an entire career. I can't really tell you much more.
Why not?
Well, because it's full of surprises, and it doubles back on itself like a snake eating its tail.
Ooh.
And it'll play with your brain, and it'll touch your heart. This is a really good movie. I may watch it again.
I have time for only one movie this weekend, Don. What should I go? What should we go to see?
Well, Predestination for your mind and Chef for your stomach.
All right, Don Morton, film critic for Metropolis Magazine. Thank you very much.
Thank you.